Hi, Nana. Yes, in this video, we start a new lesson. Okay, question bank one of study of first element hydrogen. Okay, so in this, the first question is, it is related to fill in the blanks. Okay, so some options, some answers are given. Okay, we have to identify the correct answer. First question, under first question there are sub questions. Sub question A, most of the hydrogen occurs in the combined state. Okay, most of the hydrogen occur in the combined state in the form of dash. So hydrogen is available in the combined state in the form of water. In the form of water. Okay, so most of the hydrogen is available in the form of water instead of in the form of mineral. So the hydrogen is available in the form of what? Water. Most of the hydrogen is available in the form of water only on the earth crust, mainly in the earth crust. So next question is, hydrogen is not collected by the downward displacement. Hydrogen is not collected by the downward displacement. By the downward displacement of air, by the downward displacement of the air. Okay, hydrogen is not collected by the downward displacement of air because it forms dash. It forms dash. Explosive mixture. Okay. And another option is reaction. Explosive mixture and reaction. Okay, with air. See, the question is, hydrogen is not collected by the downward displacement of air. Already we learnt that hydrogen is collected by the downward displacement of water, not by the downward displacement of air. Why it is not collected by the downward displacement of the air? Because this hydrogen can form a explosive mixture with air. Hydrogen will form explosive mixture. Okay, explosive mixture with air. Hence the answer is explosive mixture. Okay, it forms explosive mixture. Explosive mixture. Okay. What is the meaning of explosive? Explosive, that means in Telugu we will call it as payload padartham. Okay. Right. Next, see, arsenic gas is an impurity. Arsenic gas is an impurity. Arsenic gas is an impurity. Okay, present in hydrogen. There are so many impurities present in hydrogen. Okay, phosphine gas, sulfur dioxide gas, nitrogen oxides, okay, H2S, okay, so etc. So these are some of the impurities. So in the same way, arsenic is also one of the impurity. Arsenic gas is an impurity present in the hydrogen, okay, which can be removed. So this impurity, arsenic gas, okay, which can be removed by passing the
hydrogen gas, because that hydrogen gas is having some impurity. So this impurity is also present. So how to remove this impurity from the hydrogen gas? So it can be removed by passing the hydrogen gas through dash gas, hydrogen gas through, by passing the hydrogen gas through dash, okay, sodium hydroxide or silver nitrate solution, dash solution. So in the bracket, sodium hydroxide, this is one option, and silver nitrate is another option. Silver nitrate, okay. So here we have to use a silver nitrate solution. Suppose if impurities are arsine, what is the formula of arsine? ASH3, okay. So this is the formula of arsine gas. It's a poisonous gas. Arsine gas is a poisonous gas. So when arsine gas is present, or else even phosphine gas also, pH3 is called as phosphine. Okay, when phosphine gas or else arsine gases are present in the hydrogen gas, so then those gases can be removed by using with the help of what? A silver nitrate solution. With the help of silver nitrate solution. Okay. Right. Next question. Sub question D of question bank. I mean question number one. We'll see the sub question D. What is sub question D? Hydrogen mixed with dash. Hydrogen mixed with dash. So what should be this dash contain? Argon or helium? Okay, so we have to fill the appropriate word. So argon or helium. Hydrogen mixed with dash is used. Dash is used for filling whether observation below. For filling weather observation balloon. So what is the answer? So answer is helium gas, because helium is the lightest gas. Next to hydrogen is helium only. So the lightest gas is hydrogen, and next to lightest gas is helium. So in order to use the gases mixture, so we have to use hydrogen as well as helium, because both of them are light gases, lightweight gases. Argon is heavy gas somewhat. See, the weight of helium is 4 units, whereas the weight of argon is 20 units. Okay, so that means for filling weather observation balloons, we use a mixture of hydrogen gas and helium gas, because it is, helium is non-reactive. Helium does not react with hydrogen. We should not fill air. Okay, so helium, as it is lighter in weight and non-reactive, it is an inert gas. Hence, hydrogen is mixed with the helium gas for filling the weather observation balloons. Okay, right. Next, we will look into the second question. What is the second question? Second question. Match the statements in column A. Match the statements in column A with the statements in column B. With the statements in column B, in column B. So there are two columns. Okay, so column A, column A and column B are given. So we have to match these the statements of column A, okay, with the column B. So first statement. So the first statement in column A. What is the first statement? The process by which the process by which vegetable oil changes. Vegetable oil the process by which vegetable oil changes into vanaspati ghee Vanaspati ghee. What is vanaspati ghee? Vanaspati ghee means dalda. Vanaspati ghee. So vanaspati is nothing but dalda. It is also called as margarine. It is also called as margarine or else dalda. Okay, dalda. Okay, the material, solid material. Okay, which is used for cooking purpose. Okay, so that is nothing but vanaspati ghee is also called as dalda or margarine. Okay, so this is the question. So that means what process? Okay, see here vegetable oil is converted into vanaspati ghee. See how dalda is prepared. Dalda is prepared from vegetable oils like groundnut oil or palm oil or else any other oils, okay, from other oil, other vegetable oils, will prepare vanaspati ghee, okay, by a special process. So, what is the name of that process? It is asked in the question. So, now here, under column B, there are certain answers. So, we have to find which answer is suitable for the question A. So, water, calcium, and the third one is hydrogenation. Hydrogenation. So, which is the suitable answer? Hydrogenation is the suitable answer. Okay, hydrogenation is the suitable answer. Hydrogenation is nothing. What is hydrogenation? Hydrogenation means addition of hydrogen. So, what happens? This hydrogen is added to vegetable oil. Okay, hydrogen gas is added to a vegetable oil and it is heated to around 200 degrees centigrade. What happens? That hydrogen will react with the vegetable oil. Okay, the molecules of vegetable oil will react with hydrogen. Okay, in the presence of a special catalyst known as nickel catalyst. Okay, nickel catalyst, in the presence of nickel catalyst, the hydrogen gas react with vegetable oil, and finally that vegetable oil will convert into vanaspati ghee. Okay, right. So the process of reaction of hydrogen gas with the vegetable oil and convert into vanaspati ghee is said to be hydrogenation. Okay. Next, second question. A liquid which turns anhydrous copper sulfate. Okay, solution, anhydrous copper sulfate solution. Okay, to blue, anhydrous copper sulfate solution, it is converted to blue. So which liquid is used to turn anhydrous copper sulfate solution blue? What is the meaning of anhydrous copper sulfate? Anhydrous copper sulfate means CuSO4, anhydrous copper sulfate. So when anhydrous copper sulfate, it is mixed with water, what happens? It forms a blue solution. The solution of copper sulfate with water is blue in color. So remember, this is most important thing. So a liquid which turns anhydrous copper sulfate solution blue is what? Water is the liquid. Okay, so answer is water. Okay, so what is the answer for this question? So answer for this question is 3. And answer for this question is 1. Okay, next. What is the other sub-question in question 2? A metal which dissolves in water to form Milky White solution is formed. Okay, so which metal when reacted with water to form Milky White solution? So answer is calcium. When calcium is added to water, immediately the reaction takes place between calcium metal and water and forms a calcium hydroxide. It is also called as lime water. Okay, and hydrogen gas is released in this process. So here, due to the formation of this calcium hydroxide, okay, so what happened, that that portion where the calcium hydroxide is present in the water, so it appears to be milky white. Okay, it appears to be milky white. So here, a metal which dissolves in water to form milky white solution and hydrogen gas, and hydrogen gas. So what is that metal we have to identify? Okay, so what is the answer? So calcium. So there is first option is for question A, third option is for question B. So only one option is left over, that is calcium. And even calcium, we have to learn about this one. So that this is most important. Okay, right. So suppose if this is the water, if I add calcium metal into this, what happens? Slowly this calcium metal will dissolve in water. Okay, slowly it will dissolve. So it keep on dissolving. So what happens? So it will become smaller in size, because as it is used up in the reaction, this reaction will take place when calcium metal is added to water. So what happens? The big size calcium metal piece will convert into, will slowly decreases in size because it is used up in the chemical reaction. So finally, what happens? It will disappear. At last, that calcium metal will disappear. So here, what happens? So the solution which surrounds this calcium metal, the solution which surrounds this calcium metal will become white. Okay, the solution which surrounds this calcium metal will become white in color. So because here the calcium hydroxide which is formed, so it will be spread here. It will spread here, hence this portion where calcium hydroxide is present, it appears to be milky white. Okay, right. So this is about the second question. Okay, right. We learn the now we'll learn the third question. Okay, next to third question is there are some statements given, okay, and those are incorrect statements, and we have to write the correct statements for those incorrect statements. For example, in third question, sub question A, it is mentioned as hydrogen belongs to first A group and a second period of the periodic table. So this is wrong because hydrogen belongs to first A group only. Okay, no doubt. But it is not second period. It belongs to first period only. Okay, so this is incorrect statement. So how do you correct this? So this statement can be corrected simply by correcting this one. So that means it belongs to first period. Okay, first period of the periodic table. So this is wrong, and if you correct it, then we can write like this. So hydrogen belongs to first A group and first period of periodic table. So that is the right answer. Okay, na? So simply we have to correct here. Right, next one. Next question is B question. Most of the mass of stars and our sun, sun consists of carbon. Okay, so how to correct this one? So it is incorrect statement because already it is mentioned that the statements given below are incorrect. Okay, we have to correct it. So how to correct this one? See, stars and a sun, it contains large amount of hydrogen gas. So that means the mass of the stars and the sun is due to hydrogen, not due to carbon. So due to carbon, it is wrong. So what is the answer? It should be hydrogen. Hydrogen gas. So stars and sun is made up of hydrogen gas. Okay, most of the mass of stars and our sun consists of what? Hydrogen. So hydrogen is correct and carbon is incorrect. Okay, so here which one is incorrect? Second period is incorrect. First period is correct one. Okay. Next, third question in C sub question in third question. What is C sub question? Water gas. Water gas is a mixture of equal volumes of hydrogen and water vapor. Equal volumes of hydrogen and water vapor. So this is incorrect statement. So how to correct it? See, actually water gas, what is the formula of water gas? Carbon monoxide and hydrogen. So equal volumes of carbon monoxide and hydrogen mixture is said to be water gas. So here here water, it should not be water vapor. So what should be here? It should be carbon monoxide. It should be, when carbon monoxide is present, then it will be correct answer. So this is wrong. So water vapor is not not present in the water gas. Water gas is a mixture of equal volumes of hydrogen gas and carbon monoxide gas. Okay. So like this, we can correct this C option. Next, D option. Sorry, D question. In the third question, D sub question is also present. So what is that D sub question we will learn? Sub question D. Okay, during the water gas shift reaction, the carbon monoxide is reduced to the carbon monoxide. Okay, the carbon monoxide is reduced to carbon dioxide. Okay, so this is the statement, and this is wrong statement. This is incorrect statement, so we have to correct it. See, actually, water gas shift reaction. So in water gas shift reaction, carbon monoxide, actually, water gas shift reaction, carbon monoxide is removed from water gas. Okay, so here from this one, from the mixture of water gas, this is removed. This is removed by converting this one into carbon dioxide. That means carbon monoxide, it is converted to carbon dioxide. So here what has happened? Carbon monoxide is converted to carbon dioxide. So that means one oxygen is added to this one. So one oxygen is, after addition of oxygen to carbon monoxide, it will convert into carbon dioxide. Hence, addition of oxygen is said to be oxidation. It is oxidation. But here it is given as reduced. Carbon monoxide is oxidized to carbon dioxide. So carbon monoxide is oxidized to what? Carbon dioxide. So here it is given as carbon monoxide is reduced to carbon dioxide. So it is wrong. So carbon monoxide, it is oxidized to carbon dioxide. Okay, so in this way, this third question can be learnt. Okay, so there are four different sub questions. So we learnt all those four different sub questions in third question. Okay, now we will learn the fourth question. What is fourth question? Right. So fourth question. Even fourth question is also having some sub questions. Okay, sub question A of fourth question. Hydrogen can be prepared by the action of most reactive metals. Most reactive metals. There are so many ways hydrogen can be prepared. So this is one method. By the action of most reactive metals with cold water. With cold water. Okay, most reactive metals with cold water. Name three such metals. Name three such metals. Okay, we have to mention the name of three highly reactive metals that can react with cold water to prepare hydrogen gas. And write fully balanced equation. And write fully balanced equations for their reaction with water. Reactions with the water. So that is a question. How to answer such question? Hydrogen can be prepared by the action of most reactive metals. Okay, name three such metals. So what are those metals? So in the metal activity series, so potassium, sodium and calcium, these metals are said to be most reactive metals. And after calcium, the metals which come after calcium are less reactive. Okay, so here these three are the most reactive metals that can react with cold water, and all other metals they does not react with cold water. Okay, what is the element after calcium? Magnesium, okay, aluminum, zinc, etc. So these elements, they do not react with cold water. Okay, they will react only with steam. That too, these elements have to be heated. Only upon heating these elements, only upon heating these metals, and with hot water means steam. So then only these elements will react with water. That means they do not react with cold water. These elements only can react with cold water because they are highly reactive. As they are highly reactive, they can react even with cold water. But these are less reactive, hence they cannot react with cold water. These metals should be heated, and after heating only they will react with the steam, not with the cold water. Okay, they will react only with steam, and that too they have to heat it to red hot, okay, or else white hot. Sorry, okay, let it be. See, these are the three elements which are the most reactive metals that can react with cold water. Now we have to write the fully balanced equation. We have to write the fully balanced equation for their reactions. Potassium. When potassium reacts with cold water, okay, potassium, it reacts with cold water. So we should not take hot water. If you take hot water, what happened? These elements, they will explode. They are explosive. The reactions are explosive reactions. So that is why we should not take at all hot water. Even with cold water also, these elements, they react explosively. Mainly these two reacts explosively. And this will react violently. Okay. So if you see the reaction, fully balanced equation. So potassium metal with water, it forms potassium hydroxide, okay, along with the liberation of hydrogen gas is liberated. Okay, so here if you balance it, you will get the balanced equation like this. Even sodium also when react with water, okay, it forms its hydroxide, sodium hydroxide. Okay, plus hydrogen gas is liberated in this reaction. Okay, if you balance it, so we'll get like this. And calcium, when calcium reacts with water, it forms calcium hydroxide. It forms a calcium hydroxide. Okay, CaOH taken twice. What is the formula of calcium hydroxide? CaOH taken twice. And in this process also, hydrogen gas is liberated. Okay. So this is the balanced chemical equation. So this is the answer for the question, sub-question A. Okay. Next is sub-question B. What is the sub-question B? So these are the elements. These are the elements, not these elements. So I am not writing these elements. I am removing these elements. These are less reactive metals. Only these are highly reactive metals. They react even with cold water. Even with cold water. Okay, they react even with cold water. But other metals, they do not react with cold water. Right. So, next, in fourth question, there is another sub-question. What is that sub-question? Sub-question B. Sub-question B. Arrange the metals, okay, in A means question A. Already what are the, already we learnt these three metals in question A, okay. So here, in question B, we have to arrange the metals in A. So already A metals related to A, okay, these three we have to arrange, okay. Arrange the metals in A in increasing order, in increasing order of metal activity series, metal increasing order of metal activity series. So we have to arrange these elements. We have to arrange these elements in increasing order. Okay, increasing order of what? Metal activity. So out of these three, which one is more active metal? Potassium is more active metal, and calcium is less active metal, and sodium, it is intermediate between potassium and calcium. So we have to arrange in increasing order. That means first we have to so now it is answer B. Okay, first we have to write the low reactive metal, then we have to write the more reactive metal, and afterwards most reactive metal. So here this is increasing order of reactivity, metal activity series. Okay, this is the increasing order of metal activity. So in the increasing order, first we will write a low reactive metal, and finally last we will write a highly reactive metal. Okay, so this is, as we move from left to right, so the activity of metals increases. Okay, right. So this is the order. Next, sub-question C. So in the fourth question, there is one more question, sub-question C, and even D question, D is also there. What is sub-question C of fourth question? Is it possible to collect? Is it possible to collect hydrogen directly, okay, from the most reactive metals? From the most reactive metals? Most reactive metals are nothing but highly reactive metals. Okay. Is it possible to collect hydrogen directly from the most reactive metals? Okay. Named by you. So already we have mentioned we have mentioned what are the most reactive metals. So these are the most reactive metals. So from these metals, in order to collect a hydrogen gas, that means already we learned that these metals, when react with water, they form hydrogen gas. Already we learned. Okay, this hydrogen gas, can we collect this hydrogen gas when highly reactive metals are used? Okay, directly can we collect this hydrogen gas? No, we cannot collect. Though hydrogen gas is formed, we cannot collect hydrogen gas. It is not possible to collect hydrogen because if you take potassium, it is explosive reaction. For example, look here. Suppose this is cold water. Okay, cold water. If I put a piece of potassium metal, what happens? It reacts with water. This potassium reacts with water to form potassium hydroxide, and a hydrogen gas is also released. Okay, so what happens? This hydrogen gas which is released, it reacts with atmosphere and immediately forms, it catches flame. So that means this potassium, the reaction with water, it is an explosive reaction. It catches flame. It is an explosive reaction. So when the reaction is explosive, we cannot collect a hydrogen gas. Directly, we cannot collect a hydrogen gas because the reaction is explosive. So what is the answer? No, we cannot. We cannot collect a hydrogen directly by using what? By using highly reactive metal, or else by using most reactive metals. By using most reactive metals, we cannot collect a hydrogen gas directly. Why? Because the reaction is explosive in nature. The reaction is explosive in nature. As the reaction is explosive in nature, okay, as the reaction is explosive in nature, we cannot collect the hydrogen gas. Okay, right. So this is answer for the sub-question C. And one more sub-question is present in the fourth question. What is the other sub-question in the fourth question? D. So sub-question D in the fourth question. Suggest a method. Suggest a method for collecting hydrogen. Okay. Suggest a method for collecting hydrogen from the most reactive metals. Named by us. Okay. Okay. So, named by you. So, here we have named some most reactive metals. What are those most reactive metals? One is potassium. Another one is sodium, another one is calcium. So, here the question is, we have to suggest a method for what? For collecting hydrogen from the most reactive metals. See, these metals are most reactive, First of all, we have to convert these metals into less reactive metals. How to convert these metals into less reactive metals? For example, take potassium. When potassium or sodium, potassium, when it is mixed with mercury, when potassium is mixed with mercury, what happened? This potassium will dissolve in mercury. When potassium is mixed with mercury, it dissolves. This will dissolve in mercury. Okay. And the dissolved potassium in mercury, what happens? This will form an alloy. This is called as amalgam. So when a metal dissolved in mercury, then it forms amalgam. Amalgam. Which amalgam? It is called as potassium amalgam. It is called as potassium amalgam. If you dissolve sodium in mercury, then it is called as sodium amalgam. Okay. Maybe sodium amalgam or potassium amalgam, whatever it may be. So what happens? Now this mixture, in this mixture, sodium is present in the dissolved state. Okay. Now this sodium, it will be less reactive. Whereas direct sodium is more active. So if it is more active, the reaction will be explosive. Okay, sodium when react with cold water, it forms water, sodium hydroxide and a hydrogen gas. Okay, it is explosive in nature. But here if you mix sodium with mercury, okay, and this mixture, if it is kept under water, what happens? Okay, if you kept this amalgam and under water, okay, for example, suppose this is water, this is cold water, okay, here it's a jar, gas collecting jar. It is also initially filled with water. Okay, right. Next, suppose if you put a mixture of this one, sodium and mercury amalgam, what happens? So here this sodium will be less reactive. Okay, so here also the same reaction takes place. Here also sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas is liberated. Okay, but here this is more reactive, but this sodium is less reactive. That means what we are doing? So we are reducing the activity of metal. We are reducing the activity of metal by dissolving that metal in mercury. Whenever the activity of metal is reduced, what happens? So the hydrogen gas is, which is liberated, it can be collected easily. But the directly, if you use a highly reactive metal directly, we cannot collect the hydrogen gas. Even here also hydrogen gas is formed, but we cannot collect because that reaction is explosive. But this reaction is not explosive. This reaction is not explosive because mercury is present, sodium is dissolved in mercury, hence it is less reactive. Okay. So what happened? Slowly hydrogen gas is formed. That hydrogen gas the bubbles of hydrogen gas will move up and it will settle at the bottom. Okay, it will be settled at the bottom. So now hydrogen gas is collected here and it will push the water down, it will displace the water down, and here the hydrogen gas, actually here water should be there, but as hydrogen gas is collected here, so water, it is displaced downwards. That means it is pushed downwards. So the method of collection of hydrogen gas here is by downward displacement method. Okay, downward displacement of water. Downward displacement of water. Okay, the method of collection of hydrogen. This is called as the method of collection of hydrogen. How do you collect the hydrogen gas? Simply by downwarding, by displacing the water downward. So actually water was there here before collection of hydrogen. But hydrogen gas will accumulate here. As hydrogen gas is collected here, what happened? The water which is present already, it will be pushed down. It will be displaced down. Hence, the method is said to be downward displacement of water. Okay, so like this, sodium, or else, this, this is the method, okay, by which we can collect the hydrogen gas even from most reactive metals. So, what we have to do, these most reactive metals should be converted into less reactive metals. How to convert the most reactive metals into less reactive metals? Simply dissolve the most reactive metals in mercury, so that the activity of most reactive metals will be reduced, and then we can collect the hydrogen gas. Okay, right. We'll learn the other things in the next video.